Hey guys, this video is a Winter Wonderland collaboration. I'm gonna show you guys how to pack for our winter ski trip, but I'm just gonna focus on the clothes today. I've been traveling for 5 years. Every winter we go to Colorado or we go to Tahoe or Utah, someplace we can go snowboarding. So I know what to bring and what not to bring. I've been able to condense my clothes to a little bag like this that fits on most planes and carry-on, so you don't even have to pay extra for it. And I've been able to fit all these clothes. So I'm gonna start with snacks, because snacks are my favorite thing. I always make sure to bring protein shakes with me, and I always make sure to bring protein bars. And if you're going on a winter trip out to like a high altitude ski resort, make sure you carb up. You might be tempted to just eat regularly, eat your, you know, high protein diet, or drink alcohol, or do anything like that, and it's just gonna make you feel really crappy when you get there. So what I have with me right now is this Vega all natural plant-based protein shake. I like this because it's plant-based, so it just digests really well. It's really absorbable. It comes with a ton of vitamins and nutrients. It's 50% of all the vitamins you need for a whole day. I have chocolate, I have vanilla, I have chai, I have like all the spectrum of flavors that they offer, and I absolutely love their company. They're amazing. Another product I love, Clif Bars. Can't go wrong with these. They're just, a lot of people get these assuming that they're like a protein bar, but they're really not. They're more like a carb bar. They're for like energy. So they have 41 grams of carbs in this, but they have only 9 grams of protein. So I think that this is great for being out in the mountain if you're trying to keep your energy levels high while you're snowboarding or skiing or even hiking. So now I'm going to start with the comfy stuff. I borrow my boyfriend's shirts usually for pajamas because they're really comfortable and loose. This is another really comfy shirt that I actually got for my boyfriend, but I wanted to show it to you guys because you can see it's like all like velvety and silky. It's actually like a undershirt for going out snowboarding. It's like a first layer to keep you warm. And I like to wear this as like a just comfy around the house outfit, like, because it's just so warm. Gotta bring a t-shirt that's comfy just to wear, to work out, to sleep in. Got this at Venice Beach, I love it. Got this little cute crop top sweatshirt, and I can wear this out if I want to wear something casual and comfy out, or I can wear it around the apartment, and it's really nice. You might want to pack your pajamas on the top, because you don't want to have to dig through everything or unpack just to get to your pajamas. So I always pack my pajamas on top just in case. I pack whatever I know I'm going to wear right away on the top. These wonderful sweatpants. They're from, I just wanted to tell you this brand because they're just so great. It's called Hippie Love. I don't know if this is like a local brand where I got this or if this is like something you can get online, but these pants are so soft and comfortable. They're probably meant to be worn kind of out, like as like just comfortable sport, like sweatpants, but I like to wear them as pajamas. I brought 5 pairs of leggings, all black. I like to bring a lot of leggings because I wear leggings like all the time. I feel like they're more comfortable than jeans, so the ones I got are like kind of insulated on the inside, so they're great for cold weather. I'm like actually like starting to sweat right now wearing this, and I have the window open and it's 30 degrees out. So you can never go wrong with bringing a ton of leggings. Now for ski stuff, I have this undershirt. It's actually like a surf shirt. It was really cheap. I got it in the kids section at a store in Hawaii. I have these pants, which are inside out, by Sophie. They are just basic workout leggings, but they make a great base layer also. This shirt, I got this, well, I guess it's a jacket. This is Nike. It's adorable. It's good for running, it's warm. You can wear it as a base layer. You know, I actually would wear this over that shirt on a really cold day, or I could wear it over a tank top on a somewhat warmer day. Got this little juicy sweat jacket from like who knows how many years ago. For my nice shirts, I have this one that I'm wearing right now, which I got at Joyce Leslie for like, I think $12. And it's just a cute Christmassy red shirt. It's comfortable, makes a good base layer, or it's great to go out in. Got these thermals. Thermals are always cute. They're fitted, they look nice. I could dress this up. I actually brought almost only thermals with me because they're so comfortable. I went on a Euro trip last, like a little over a month ago, and I just brought thermals with me and I wore them every day. I also brought a ton of like dressy shirts and I didn't wear any of them. So I learned a good lesson that I'm just gonna probably wear these shirts and not wear the other things for my future trips. So this shirt's from Free People. It's adorable. It's a little expensive, but it's worth it because it's just, the material is great. It's really nice. It can be worn casually, or you could wear this to go out. It could look dressy. It's long. It comes down, so you can wear it over leggings and not feel like you're too exposed. So I really like this. I also got this one from Free People, this brown one. It has these really cute embroidered sleeves, and it makes a great shirt for cold weather like this because it's some thick thermal material. It's stretchy, so it looks cute. It's flattering. And I love it. I have this shirt, which is inside out, but I got this also at Joyce Leslie. I don't know if you guys have that by you. It has these lace like lining on the sleeve, so it's like this space of lace where you can see your skin underneath it. Not the warmest, but it is nice. Also have this shirt, which is also inside out, which is black. It's just like a stretchy long sleeve shirt. Can look great with a pair of jeans. It also makes good base layer for going out snowboarding. Almost done. I have this cute little crop sweater that I wear to go out. It's like a, more of like a dressy sweater. I wear this over like a long sleeve shirt when it's cold out, and I could put a pair of leggings underneath, and I wear my shawl over my shoulders. Pair of jeans. These are Citizens of Humanity. They're essential. I like don't like any of the other jeans I have at home, and most jeans that I try on I hate, so these jeans were like the best ones ever. Avedon low-rise skinny leg. I have these dress shoes that I bring just in case, but I haven't even worn them yet and I've been here a week already. So that's mostly it for my clothes that I actually put in the bag. My protein bars and my protein shakes I could put with my socks, or I could put it on the outside. You could fit a whole ton of hats, socks, or whatever you want in there. It's perfect. And then my extensions, AKA my weave. I bring this once in a while just in case I want to dress the hair up. They're beautiful. And I have a couple of layers aside from my snowboarding jacket. I have this like fake fur shawl, shrug or whatever you call this. And it looks kind of silly like this, but it's very warm. And what I could do is add this basic leathery, fake leather actually, fake leather jacket over it. And you could turn it into a really cute winter jacket. I have this puffy vest. This puffy vest goes great over everything. So I really like layering in weather like this. With everything I brought, I'm totally comfortable in Colorado at 9,000 feet when it's 35 degrees during the day and in the 20s at night. If you're bringing hats like this, my new favorite one, and socks for snowboarding or your boots, you could pack everything, including your pants, your jacket, your pass, whatever else you have, your gloves, in your snowboarding bag. I definitely think you can just get away with a little bag like this, which is gonna be perfect for a carry-on, and it's gonna cover the weight. It's not gonna be anything over like, I think it's like under 25 pounds. So I hope you guys liked this video. It was really fun to make and kind of like put all my clothes together and once again look at all the things I brought with me on this trip. So I hope this helped you guys out a little bit. I look forward to hearing what you guys are doing this winter. Are you guys going on any vacations, anywhere cold, anywhere warm? If you're going anywhere cold, everything I packed works for me, so it should definitely work for you. And if you guys are looking for advice on winter hairstyles or winter like packing in terms of toiletries or makeup and stuff like that, winter favorites, me and a bunch of girls put together a winter collaboration, and I'm gonna post a playlist below that links to all the videos. So if you guys are looking to pack anything else or get any more information, you could check that out and it'll totally help you out. So I'll see you guys soon. Bye.